guys, this is Becky with Design Bundles, and today I'm excited to share with you in a new area that I've been adventuring into, and that is working with the iPad and Procreate. Now, before we get too crazy, I am not an iPad or Procreate specialist, but what I want to share with you are just some beginner tips for being able to take things from Procreate on your iPad and bring them into your Cricut Design Space or Silhouette Studio. I'm going to show you in Cricut Design Space, but it's just a matter of being able to get this whatever you have created over into your designing software to use with your cutting machine or Sublimation. So I'm really excited to share this with you. Let's go ahead and get started.
Okay, so here I am in Procreate, and we are simply going to hit the plus icon, and I'll just use screen size. I'm gonna create a new document. Now I do have the Apple Pencil, and this is an older generation iPad Pro, but if this is something you're looking at getting into, definitely check out the newer generation iPads, because I believe that they have loosened up the iPads that you can use the pencil on. So once I'm in here, I can use any kind of doodles that I want to. So if I need to, I can doodle a heart, okay? I can do a flower if I need to. Now, I know that you can buy clip art, okay, that will take care of this for you. And hey, if that is your strong suit, then far be it for me to stand in your way. I'm not trying to say that you have to use the iPad to do your doodles. Heck, you can even doodle on just a regular pen and pencil piece of paper, right? But this is just a way, if you are a doodler, and I enjoy doodles, you know, then you can come in here and you can create your own doodles and be able to use them with your Cricut or Silhouette. So you can draw anything you want. You can even do your hand lettering, which I am not a pro at. Okay, so once you get done with your doodles, and like I said, you can come in here and draw pretty much anything and everything that you have in mind. And like I said, I'm not a Procreate specialist. This is just the very basic doodling with very basic brushes, but hopefully we'll be able to expand on these for you in the future. But once you get done, you're going to go back to your gallery, and then you can hit select and select the item that you were working on. And up at the top, you can hit share, and then it will allow you to select which one you want to share. So I'm going to share in a PNG format. It will show exporting, and then I usually use email, and I will just email this to myself and be able to open this on my computer so that I can bring it in to either Cricut Design Space or Silhouette Studio, whichever I prefer. And then of course it'll also be saved here in Procreate in case I want to come in and do any editing in the future. Okay, so your next step is going to be opening up your email, and you can simply access the email that you sent yourself. And here's our PNG, so we will download that. And then from our downloads folder, we can import it straight into the software. So let's use Cricut Design Space for example. So in Cricut Design Space, we can just go to Upload, Upload Image. And here in our Downloads folder, that is exactly the doodles that we created. We can do complex or simple. I'm going to hit Continue. And then I just want to click on that white background, and that will delete out all the pieces that we don't want. So that's why I like to use black and white if this is something that I'm creating as a cut file, because what that means is that I can just go in and take out all of the white pieces, and it just makes it super, super simple. Now, if I was drawing a doodle or artwork that I wanted to use as a print and cut, then that is not what we would be doing right now. So if I zoom out, just check it over. Looks like all of the white is taken out. Hit continue. And we can click over here, save as a cut image, and hit save. And it's going to save this into our recently uploaded images so that we can use it in our canvas. So I'm just going to click on that and hit insert images. and that will import straight into my canvas. So from here, I can size it whatever size I need. There we go. Now the only thing is that when you import and trace like this, you cannot ungroup it. So you will just have to go to contour if there was anything that you wanted to leave out. And once you do that, then of course you have isolated that and you can use it any way that you want to. So if you were going to do this in Silhouette Studio, you would simply go to File and Merge, and you would bring in that document, and you can enlarge it. All of our pieces are there, and then you would trace them. So those are the two biggest differences between using this with Cricut and using this with Silhouette, is that with Cricut, you'll bring it in, and the tracing happens automatically, whereas in Silhouette Studio, you're going to go in here, and you're going to manually trace these before you would be able to use them. So other than that, this is really how easy it is to be able to bring something over from your iPad to either one of these softwares. And as you get more and more proficient at it, I'm sure you'll be able to do this even quicker using the USB cord or anything like that. But for now, this works really well for me. This is what I'm familiar with, so it's what I use, and I'm pretty darn happy with it.
So, wasn't that easy? I mean, like, don't get me wrong, it's not rocket science, but, you know, I was really surprised at just how easy it is to take those little things that we just kind of take for granted, okay, at least I do anyway, and I may search and search and search, and then come to find out it's something I could have just knocked out on my iPad and moved along with my life. So, I really hope that you guys enjoyed it today. I hope that we will be able to bring you more tutorials like this with Procreate and your iPad in the future. All right, fingers crossed on that one. But, if there's anything else that you guys want to see, we do listen. We are all ears. Whatever you guys want to see, we will do our best to accommodate. And, just make sure you subscribe, because that's how you're going to get all the notifications for all the wonderful videos that we have. So, all right, guys, I'm going to wrap it up, but I appreciate you stopping by today. Hit that subscribe button for me, and we will see you again next time. Bye.